When you turn on the tap, you expect the water to flow, but there's a lot of work behind the scenes to make that happen. Water embarks on an incredible journey before it reaches your faucet, with help from municipal water agencies. Nearly 90% of Southern Nevada's drinking water begins as snow or rain in the Rocky Mountains of Colorado. After the snow melts and drains into the river, the water travels hundreds of miles before reaching Lake Mead. The Southern Nevada Water Authority draws and pumps this water to its state-of-the-art water treatment facilities. Following treatment that ensures water meets all state and federal Safe Drinking Water Act standards, water flows through an intricate network of pipes, pumps, and reservoirs before reaching its final destination, your home. As a regional agency, the Water Authority secures long-term water resources and oversees conservation planning. The Water Authority also provides water treatment and wholesale delivery for Southern Nevada, delivering treated drinking water from Lake Mead to area water providers, who then deliver water to you, the customer. SNWA helps to ensure safe and reliable water delivery by operating two of the nation's most advanced water treatment facilities, River Mountains and Alfred Merritt Smith.
Between the two plants, we can produce 900 million gallons per day. So we bring the water in from the lake through the third intake, and they can come to the two plants. They have the ability to split the flow, so both plants can operate at the same time, giving us a lot of redundancy, which is really great for our community. Well, we're blessed to have two laboratories here at the River Mountains plant. One lab is for compliance, and they assure that our water quality meets the Safe Drinking Water Act. The other laboratory is a research laboratory, which helps develop procedures for looking at other chemicals, emerging contaminants, and other byproducts that we worry about in the distant future.
Water quality starts at Lake Mead, the largest man-made reservoir in the nation. Spanning nearly 250 square miles, Lake Mead is also impressively deep. The Water Authority's third intake plumbs these depths to draw the freshest, purest water. The third intake is designed to maintain access to our community's primary water supply, even as lake levels continue to decline.
The third intake allows us to take water from deeper portions of the lake. As the lake level drops, the surface gets closer to the intakes. The third intake, being much deeper, allows us to get better quality water. In doing so, it's easier to treat, it's easier to disinfect, it takes less ozone, and it provides better quality water to our customers.
To further protect the community's water supply, the SNWA is building a new pumping station at Lake Mead. It will work in tandem with the third intake to keep water flowing to more than 2 million Valley residents. When the pumping station is completed in 2020, SNWA will have the ability to draw water from the lake, even if lake levels drop too low for Hoover Dam to release water to downstream users in California, Arizona, and Mexico. Once water travels through intake number 3 to SNWA's treatment facilities, state-of-the-art ozonation is the primary treatment process. Ozone provides an effective disinfectant that destroys bacteria and waterborne pathogens. The next step in treatment is multistage filtration, which includes a step known as flocculation. Particles in the water form clumps called flock. The flock is so small it can't be seen by the naked eye. Flocculated water passes through multiple filters that trap and remove these particles. Chlorine is then added to water as it leaves the treatment facilities. Both chlorine and corrosion control efforts further protect water as it journeys through the pipeline distribution system, sometimes 30 miles or more uphill, on its way to you.
Most of our system is fed what we call a gravity-fed system, and this means that we just work on the natural principle that water flows downhill. All of our storage reservoirs are located at an elevation higher than the area that they serve, and as water flows downhill, it gains pressure, and customers will see acceptable pressures at their tap. Of course, we still have to fill these reservoirs from the lake, which requires pumping, but we will do this at night when the pumping costs are lower.
Highly skilled operators guide water through a series of pumping facilities to help move water to reservoirs and water tanks throughout the community. Reservoirs provide sufficient storage to meet our home and business water needs, as well as fire protection to support our community's first responders. The Las Vegas Valley Water District and the cities of North Las Vegas and Henderson maintain more than 100 reservoir basins and tanks that collectively hold more than 1 billion gallons of water. To maintain water quality in the distribution system, operators and distribution personnel keep a watchful eye on flows, water levels, system pressures, and pumping activities. They work 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, to monitor water quality.
SCADA is the brains of our system. SCADA stands for Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition, which is a really long term for just a control room. So all of the data comes in from dozens and dozens of stations out there in the system, and we will be able to see all of the pumps, all of the flows, all of the pressures, all the residuals, anything that you'd want to see from a station, you can see right here from this room. These two operators can react to alarms that come in and know if they need to send personnel out to a site to troubleshoot something.
Considering the important role water plays in our daily lives, local water providers in Southern Nevada are committed to maintaining reliable water infrastructure that safely meets our community's water needs. By the time water reaches your tap, it's been treated and tested to the highest state and federal standards. You may not see the complex network of people, pipelines, and technology working behind the scenes, but that collaboration is behind every drop. For more information about Southern Nevada's water treatment and delivery, visit snwa.com. Reporting for Waterways, I'm Christine Vaughn.